Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hey, this is Jacob Wilson, and today I'm going to be recording some matches of the new standard format. This past weekend I played Pro Tour Cons, and I played a deck list very similar to this one that Mike Sigrist top-aided the Pro Tour with. I prepared with him, and I think the deck's very good. The mana base is pretty simple. When I first saw the new set, I thought Scrylands would be better than the Trilands. Lands that make three colors, but with more testing I can see how powerful the three color lands are, and I think they'll see a lot of play, but some decks might want the Scrylands over them. There are four fetch lands in this deck and only three targets. The curve is pretty low, but if you do need a lot of mana late in the game, particularly for Rakshasha, then Urborg will allow you to tap your fetch lands for mana, which is great. Urborg also helps with the pain lands to not deal yourself so much damage. Speaking of damage, this deck does itself a lot of damage. With the lands, Thoughtseize, Ulcerate, Herald of Torment, and Abzan Charm. Thankfully, there are a few cards in the deck that gain life. The biggest being Siege Rhino, that always gains you life. And Sorin has the most potential to gain life. You can gain as much as 20 life in one turn. So those cards are both great to offset the life loss. This deck is really resilient, and it's a good aggro deck against mid-range decks because all the creatures get around Sylvan Caryatid, unlike other aggro decks in the format. Except when this deck plays against other aggressive decks, it often has to take the control role. For example, playing against mono red or even blue white red, I would say this deck is the control. Moving on to the sideboard, this deck doesn't have a great sideboard, but that's fine. You never really want a sideboard too much in an aggro deck. We played two Erase because we had a lot of respect for the Jeskai Ascendancy combo deck. I actually played three in my deck, but Mike only played two, and Despise. You can't really have too many discard spells in certain matchups, so these are great to bring in, especially against Green Devotion. Bioblight and Drown and Sorrow are good against aggro, and they're also good against Green Devotion, particularly for Hornet Queen, which is a difficult card to beat. Silence is good in the exact mirror match to kill creatures that have a Herald of Torment on them. And anytime you really need to kill a bothersome creature, like Ashcloud Phoenix, for example. Whip is not a card I actually love, but it can be quite powerful. Wingmate Rock is a card that I do love. It's great in any sort of Abzan mirror match. Similarly to Ajani. Ajani's great in the mirror, and it's also great against control decks.